Hi everyone, Kevin here. Today, we are going to look at the best Google Maps tips and tricks. To jump around this video, feel free to use the timestamps down below. All right, let's check these out. At number one, you can zoom in and out just by using one finger. Typically, to zoom in and out, you need two fingers and you could either pinch or expand. But you can also just double tap with one finger and then slide your finger up or down to zoom in and out. At number two, you can have Google Maps remember your parking location. I always seem to forget where I park my car, but now I'll always know where my car is. Unless, of course, I park in Oklahoma City. Within Google Maps, simply tap on the blue dot that indicates where you currently are, and then you can save your parking location. On the map, you'll now see a pin that shows you where your car is. Once you return, you can click on that pin and you can clear it out. If you would rather have Google Maps remember automatically where your car is, click on your profile picture, then go to Settings, Navigation, and here you can toggle it on so Google Maps remembers your parking location. At number three, you can see where you've been using location history. Now, to be fair, this one's a little bit creepy, but also really cool. To be able to use this, you have to make sure to turn on location tracking. Click on the hamburger menu and then select your timeline. Here I see a map of the world with red dots indicating all of the different places I've been. Let's say I want to revisit my trip to Orlando, Florida. Here I'll click on the dot in Orlando. And here I can see that I flew to Orlando through Dallas. And down below I see day by day that I was on this trip. So I can click through and see every single thing that I did. If I move to the 9th, here I can see that I went on a trip to the Kennedy Space Center. And what's really neat is it also overlays your photos on your map data. So here I can see a photo of myself in front of the NASA sign. And here if I go down, I could also see the Space Shuttle Atlantis. It's pretty much like an automated diary of your life. At number four, you can time travel using something called Street View History. To access Street View, you click on the little yellow person icon in the bottom right-hand corner, and then all of the different roads will highlight in blue indicating where Street View is available. And it's truly mind-boggling how many different roads Google has covered. Here when I zoom out, you start to get a sense for the massive scope of their coverage. And it's not just roads that they've covered, they've even covered some waterways as well. To use Street View, I simply select the person icon in the bottom right, and then I could drag it onto one of the blue streets. And this will show me the most current picture of this location. In the top left-hand corner, I can see the date of the photo. But if I click on that, I can also go back in time and access past photos. So here you see that in this current photo, there are some large condo buildings at this intersection. But now if I go back in time, just a few years ago, these were all parking lots. It really shows you the massive construction growth going on in the city of Seattle right now. At number five, you can interact with Google Maps simply by using your voice. The easiest way to do that is to simply click on the microphone icon when you're navigating. But an even easier way to do that is to click on your profile picture, then click on Settings, then click on Navigation, and set it so you simply say, OK Google, and then you could ask your question. So here I am navigating, and I can say, OK Google, show me all gas stations along my route. Here now I see all of the gas stations and the associated price. If I don't care about price, I could also say, OK Google, route me to the nearest gas station. And there it is. At number six, and this is a quick one, you can change your vehicle icon. Simply tap on the arrow icon and then you can choose a different vehicle. At number seven, you can create custom labels to make it easier to get back to the places that you care about. I always use my phone to navigate to my dentist, but I never remember what the address is. So here I can simply type in the address and then I can add a label for this. And here I'll type in dentist. Now in the future, when I'm navigating, all I need to do is type in dentist and Google Maps will know exactly where that is. At number eight, you can also save a location. I'm currently pulling together a plan for a business trip at the Kevin Cookie Company, and I've always wanted to visit Hershey's Chocolate World in Pennsylvania. This will be a great opportunity to try to get some of their trade secrets. Inspiration for the Kevin Cookie Company. Here, I'll click on Save. Now I could go up to the hamburger menu, click on Your Places, and when I click into this list, here I see my saved item. I can even share this list with others so we can collaborate on pulling together the plan for this trip. At number 9, you can download offline maps. This way, if let's say you don't have internet, or maybe you want to save on bandwidth, you can use offline maps. Simply click on your profile picture, then click on offline maps. You can now create your own map. And here you can highlight the area that you want to make available offline. The larger the area, the more space the map will take, and the smaller the area, the less space the map will take. Then simply click on download when you're ready to get your offline map. At number 10, you can also measure distance and area. Here we are at Mount St. Helens, the site of the deadliest US volcano. And here I am at Johnston Ridge Observatory. Here I can right click and then select measure distance. Next, I'll click into the crater. And it looks like the observatory is about 5 miles away from the crater. So if there were another eruption and you were at the observatory with the eruption moving at 300 miles per hour, you would have about 1 minute to find your way to safety. Good luck. You can also calculate area. Here we are at Michigan Stadium. This is the largest US football stadium with over 110,000 seats. Let's say I want to know how much grass seed do I need to buy to cover the entire field. Here, I'll go to the corner of the field and then once again select measure distance. Then I can click in each corner of the field, and once I connect all of the points, I can now see the area. And it looks like 6,300 square meters. That's a lot of grass seed. At number 11, you can share your real-time location with others. Simply tap on your blue dot and then click on Share Location. You can then define how long you want to share your location for, and then who you want to share it with. The other person will then be able to see your real-time location on a map. At number 12, you can configure various route options like avoiding highways, ferries, and also tolls. To access this, click on your profile picture, then select Settings, Navigation, and here you have various route options that you can adjust. At number 13, Google Maps isn't just for the outside world. You can also see inside certain select buildings. Here I am at Bellevue Square Mall, and when I zoom in enough, I can see where each retailer is within the mall. In the bottom right-hand corner, I could even switch between the different floors within the building. At number 14, and this one's not entirely obvious on mobile, you can add multiple stops. Here, for instance, I have 2 stops already entered. I can click on the ellipsis and I can now add another stop. Once I add this stop, I can press and hold to reorder them. At number 15, Google Maps can ensure that you are always on time. I want to visit the original Ghirardelli ice cream and chocolate shop, and they open right at 11 a.m. And that's also right when I want to arrive. Instead of departing right now, if I scroll all the way to the bottom, there's the option to remind me. I could have it remind me to depart at a certain time, or I could set it to arrive by a certain time. I'm going to select arrive by and then set it to 11 a.m. This will now give me a reminder that factors in traffic when I need to leave. And at number 16, I can modify my route simply by dragging and dropping. Here, for instance, I have my route already set up. Here, I'll drag it over, and this now modifies my route to go through that point that I selected. If I want to undo this, I can simply double-click on that point, and it'll go back to the original version. At number 17, you can use Google Maps to help you navigate public transportation. When you select a start point and an end point, instead of leaving it set to the vehicle, switch it to the public transit icon. And this will show you what trains or buses or subways you need to take to get to your destination. This has saved me so many times in so many different cities. At number 18, you can view what traffic looks like at different parts of the day. In the bottom left-hand corner, I'm going to change the layer to the traffic layer. And here I see traffic right now. but I can also change this so I can see traffic at any point during the day. So if I want to know what does traffic typically look like on, say, Tuesday mornings, I can see which routes get the most congested. At number 19, you can use Google Maps to very quickly evaluate pricing for different vacation destinations. Simply select your start point and then select a destination and click on the flight icon. You can now move your destination to different locations on the map and it'll update to show what the pricing looks like. So here I could look at a few different destinations and I don't know, maybe a vacation in Hawaii looks really nice. This brings us to number 20, our very last tip of the day. I've always wondered, what is at Area 51? Here I am over the base in Nevada. Has Street View been able to penetrate the base? Here I'll click on the Street View icon and pull it over the base. And look at that, it shows a UFO. I knew it, we are not alone. Alright, let me know down below in the comments, are there any other tips that you would recommend? To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.